they tie up dead center of the circle. Zamboanga going to drive her down. She puts Jihin in her back.
Very aggressive start from both ladies, and immediately Jihin Radzuan starts attacking off her back. That's what she's known for, but it's a beautiful pass by Denice as she's able to maintain that top position, work her way into side control. You can see Jihin Radzuan's trying to grab those legs. She's trying to keep those knees nice and tight, slide those legs underneath so she can get back into half guard. And she's doing a good job of doing that. Beautiful.
Good oil on Zamboanga. A lot of word of her coming off the upset tonight. We see an aggressive start for the Filipina. Inside of half guard, top position. Where does Jihin go from here?
Well, first thing she's got to try to do is take that left arm and get underneath the arm of Zamboanga so she can maintain that underhook so she can start to move. But she's doing a really good job of getting back into full guard. And you know just how dangerous Jihin Radzuan is off her back. She loves to snatch up submission finishes. She just got one in her last matchup against Jomari Torres as she was able to sink in a submission off the rear naked of the triangle choke. She also got another one off of Pooja Tomar. She has a very aggressive bottom game. She's always looking for that submission. Looks like she might be trying to tie up that arm, looking for a possible arm bar. Zamboanga slides out that arm, though.
Radzuan hoping for back-to-back wins over Filipino opponents. The very aggressive Denice Zamboanga. Top position. Back to her feet goes Jihin Radzuan. Zamboanga swings, hooking in the punches. Looking for a takedown again with Zamboanga.
Good lateral movement from Jihin, though, as she was able to sidestep that.
And she takes out a tip for Jihin. Another back for half guard here for Zamboanga.
Man, these ladies are going at it. But Zamboanga's got to be very careful in these transitions on the bottom. That's when Jihin Radzuan is most dangerous, is when she catches you mid-transition. You leave an arm exposed or your neck out, she's going to try to take it home.
Trying to get up some ground and pound from this top position to this Zamboanga halfway through the opening stanza.
Now Jihin's got that underhook. Now she's able to start creating movement. It's all a battle on that side for that underhook to see who can control the position. Jihin's either going to try to get that underhook or she might try to retain full guard. Nice little hit bump.
Zamboanga keeping the Malaysian on her back, closing these left hands down. Side control for the Filipina. Puts the knee on the arm, pins it there.
Tried to go knee on belly, but the hips of Jihin Radzuan are constantly floating back and forth to try to control the movement of Zamboanga, but also to try to maintain either half guard or full guard. Good job by Zamboanga to get that underhook on that right side just to keep Jihin flattened out to maintain that top position.
Zamboanga tried to pass to the right side of the body, but Jihin made sure she couldn't go there. Radzuan back to her feet now. Crossing elbow with beauty. Don't forget Jihin Radzuan, Wushu champion.
Wushu world champion, too.
One of over 140 martial arts world champions on the one championship roster. Cuts off the circle nicely. Zamboanga, who spars with the great world champion, Stan Furtin.
See Zamboanga set up that right hand into a beautiful takedown attempt again. She loves those transitions from the fake to the punch. Right into a double leg or a single leg. And look how she's always falling into a more dominant position. She's not just trying to take you down and sit in your guard. She's trying to take you down and advance that position, trying to get into side control, trying to work for mount, trying to close this show.
45 seconds remaining in the first round of three. Some great stuff, particularly from Denice Zamboanga on table. Couple of right hands there from Denice. Looks to pass again. Jihin tries to get to her feet. Now she'll pop up. Zamboanga tries to bounce on her. Back against the circle here. Into the midsection there from Jihin Radzuan. Looks like we're going to see out the first round. A highly aggressive, very active opening 5 minutes for both these women.
Yeah, you can just see how these guys have. There's been no stop whatsoever. This 5 minutes has been full of constant action. This second round is going to come down to who's got the bigger gas tank. You see Zamboanga's trying to set up that right hand. She likes to throw that right as the lead punch. And Jihin Radzuan is, you know, a little bit tentative because you saw the way she flurried in and she rushes forward in that first five. She's trying to beckon her in. She's like, come on, let's dance in the center. But she's not going forward.
Denice Zamboanga pulls her in again.
They're both doing it. They're like, come on, this is my space. Enter my
last warning. Action. Last warning. Action.
Want these two ladies to go at it.
Nice right hand down the tree there from Zamboanga. And the girls of their feet. Jihin Radzuan fires out a front kick out of southpaw stance.
Like they both adjusted their striking strategy to go counter-striking, and neither one has fallen for the bait to go forward.
Good chop now, Zamboanga gets to the ground. Chop position for the Filipina. Close guard from Jihin.
I don't know if that was a takedown or if that was more of Jihin Radzuan pulling guard, but either way, Zamboanga's on top now, looking for a little bit of ground and pound. You can see just how active Jihin Radzuan is. She doesn't keep her legs wrapped around the body. She's always looking for the finish. Right now she's going for an armbar. It was a bad spot. If she can turtle over, if she can get that arm nice and tight and go belly down, this might be a wrap. But Zamboanga's got very flexible arms. You might even want to call her hypermobile. It's hard to finish her. Jihin Radzuan might need to go to a triangle if she wants to get this victory off the bat. Zamboanga, uses it beautifully to pass, sits into side control, attempted to go to the mount, chose to sit back down into side control.
Zamboanga nicely done to get out of that predicament. Side control here for the Filipina. 2:30 remains, halfway through this contest. Let's see what Zamboanga can do from this top position. She comes in tonight undefeated.
You can see she's trying, you can see how she kind of leaves her leg out there like that, like she's like trying to sprawl heavily, trying to drive her shoulder into the chin.
But that leg position
is actually enabling Jihin Radzuan to wrap up those legs and get back into half guard. She needs to get a little bit tighter, take her legs, pin her knees up to the hips, so Jihin Radzuan is not able to do that.
And the 2 minutes remains now, half guard position. Denice Zamboanga on top of Jihin Radzuan. The Philippines versus Malaysia. Watch out there from the shadow cut. Back to her feet now, Radzuan.
And it's tough to call it on these, on the ground exchanges. You know, you're seeing Zamboanga get into more dominant positions, but Jihin Radzuan's the one going for the submissions, trying to get the finish.
Let's see if Jihin can employ some of that world championship wushu now. She's calling Zamboanga forward again. Zamboanga not taking the bait, walks into a front kick. Jihin resets again, back into a forward. Zamboanga, not being sucked in though. Wild right hand there from the Filipina.
Zamboanga likes to throw that right hand going first. He's reaching into his pocket.
More action.
Gives him a yellow card. Now a yellow card, ladies and gentlemen, is a 10% purse deduction for both these ladies. It can come into scoring if the match is really close, but in this case, they're both issued the yellow card, so kind of nullifies it.
Zamboanga has Jihin Radzuan on her back again.
See, if Jihin Radzuan was trying to stop these takedowns, it would score in the takedown defense category, but she's kind of just falling into the takedown because she's so comfortable off her back looking for these submissions. Trying to trap the arm, trying to look for arm bars, trying to go for triangles. She's got to be a little bit more aggressive. She has to try to attempt sweeps. She has to get up off her back and do some damage.
Up kick there, but it wasn't enough to pick off Zamboanga. 25 seconds remain, second of three. Zamboanga hunting after the legs here. Didn't get a hold of that single leg.
Looks like the Philippines has a new underdog dog. Division that she is legit. Even if Jihin Radzuan is able to finish her or score a unanimous victory or a split.
Comes out spinning the legs of Radzuan in the pink and black. Zamboanga in the gold and black. Right hand from Zamboanga clinches up with the Malaysian, backs her against the circle fence. Knee there to the midsection from Zamboanga.
I like this change of strategy by Jihin. She's got to be a little bit more active, a little bit more aggressive. Can't be so content just to allow Denice to take her down, put her on her back, and then she's trying to look for those submissions. She has to be the initiator. She has to be aggressive. She's got 5 minutes to do it. Oh, the attack at the beautiful Uchibata fell short. Immediately starts to look for that arm, trying to trap it, looking for a triangle.
Look at Jihin Radzuan! The crowd responds!
Inching up. Denice can't allow her to adjust. You can see Jihin Radzuan's trying to punch, trying to distract Denice as she adjusts the triangle. Denice has got to look up. She's got to posture up. Can't allow her head to get pulled down so Jihin can adjust that triangle.
Deafening crowd here chanting Jihin Radzuan's name. And she finds a finish, third and final round with Denice Zamboanga.
See Zamboanga trying to sneak her left arm inside so she can have both arms inside the legs of Jihin Radzuan, and that'll nullify the triangle. Jihin's trying to adjust, trying to make the necessary adjustments when she's trying to frame, but Denice knows exactly what to do in this position. She's also in her corner right there.
Trying to find the position that might finish Denice Zamboanga. Two submissions in front of her for Jihin Radzuan. She's got two triangle chokes on her record. It's her favorite technique, her favorite submission. Did she find it here?
Go up to finish.
Trying to stab her, trying to alleviate that pressure. She's also trying to avoid Jihin Radzuan from taking her right leg and putting it on the back of her neck. She can sink that in nice and deep. See, she's trying to posture up now, create a little bit of space.
Walk to finish.
Jihin's trying to be active, but time is slowly ticking away.
And the 2.5 minutes remaining, third and final round. Zamboanga has been in this position now for a long, long time. Punching off her back, Jihin Radzuan. Looking for the opportunity to pull that head down, set that shoulder. Maybe it's an armbar switch up now.
She's trying to take that leg, her left leg, and swing her head of Zamboanga. She's got a pretty good grip on the right arm of Zamboanga. Zamboanga's got to keep her step, and then slowly,
here we go.
She can't allow Jihin Radzuan to straighten out and extend that arm. See how her arms are clasped? That's going to prevent a lot of pressure coming from Jihin Radzuan.
Meanwhile, it's all scoring very well for Jihin Radzuan. Can she take on the arm?
She's starting to extend. That's tight.
Oh, yes. Can she take that arm home?
Jihin Radzuan can finish your night with one minor mistake. And Denice just sat in this position for too long. Oh, she powers out of it and pulls her arm out.
How about that from Denice Zamboanga? 1 minute 15 remains. And can she reset the armbar attempt here? There's a shake for the moment. And six this. Jihin Radzuan. Chance for Zamboanga to posture up now. Break open the guard. The closed guard of Radzuan. 30 seconds on the clock now. Big two punches there from Zamboanga. Closes down those wrists. Throws the legs up, hoping to take on the arm. Still here, Radzuan. My guard from the Malaysian. Final 10 seconds. We're going down the judges again. Will it be back-to-back wins for the Malaysian superstars? Tani and Radzuan. We'll find out in a few...